Hi everyone! Today we check in on one of our little geniuses who happens to be waiting for her flight at the airport. It looks like a plane is about to take off. Seeing this gets her thinking about something. Does the airplane push through the air to move forward? Or since the Earth spins so fast, does the plane simply need to get into the air and the Earth will spin under it? If the latter is happening, why can't we just jump our way around the world and let the Earth spinning do the work for us? With a simple hop, skip, and a jump, we could be relaxing on a sunny beach almost instantly. Stay tuned to find out the answer to today's question. To begin to understand the answer to our question, let's get into our time machine and go back to the year 1666 to meet a man named Isaac Newton. Young Isaac Newton was studying at Cambridge University in the United Kingdom. However, due to the plague wreaking havoc across the region, all social spaces, which include schools, were closed until further notice. This meant that Newton had to return home. Being the eager student that he was, and being interested in so many different subjects, he decided to bring his studies with him. One topic that he was especially fascinated with was how the moon orbits the Earth. One day, while reading underneath an old apple tree in the front of his family home, one apple fell to the ground next to him. Eventually, another fell. Each time, Newton observed the apples to fall in the exact same path, that being straight down. This brought up an interesting question for Newton. Why were the apples falling directly down? Why couldn't they fall sideways or even upwards? He was curious by the mysterious force and contemplated at the time that the apple must be attracted to the center of the Earth. Additionally, not only is the apple drawn to the Earth, but the Earth is drawn to the apple. We now understand this force to be the force of gravity. Through Newton's lifelong research, in addition to gravity, he developed three laws of motion, which will help continue our search for the answer to our question. Newton's first law is where we will start. This law of motion states that an object at rest will stay at rest until an external force compels it to change its state, and an object that is moving will continue to uniformly move in that direction until an external force compels the object to change its state. The Earth spins at 1,000 miles per hour, or 1,600 kilometers per hour, and will continue to spin at that speed unless some external force imparts an effect to that speed. Due to the Earth's gravity, the entire world, including the land, ocean, and even the atmosphere, travels at the same speed all the time. Now you might be asking yourself, why don't we feel it if we're going that fast? This answer requires us to consider Newton's second law of motion, as well as seeing how our bodies sense movement. Newton's second law gives us the equation to calculate force. When we begin to move in a direction, the feeling of acceleration we get is partially due to having a net positive force in Newton's equation. This net force causes the otoliths to react. The otoliths are small structures in our inner ear that detect linear acceleration and orientations relative to gravity to help give our body a sense of balance. The otolith organs, consisting of the utricle, which is for linear accelerations of the head and head tilts horizontally, and the saccule, which is for linear accelerations of the head and head tilts vertically, are part of the vestibular system which helps our bodies with motion, head position, and spatial orientation. This whole system of semicircular canals are filled with a liquid called endolymph. Within this liquid, hair cells within these otolith organs detect movement when crystals of calcium carbonate, which are called otoconia, shift in response to the movement, leading to the movement in the layers below the otoconia and displacement of the hair cells. Once acceleration stabilizes, which results in Newton's equation giving no net positive force, and therefore no net acceleration, the otoliths will not react and our brains think that we are not moving. Additionally, since everything around us moves at the same speed that we are, we visually cannot tell that there is any movement around us. When you are sitting or standing on a bus, initially the accelerating vehicle will cause you to feel the increasing speed, and your body will have to adapt to maintain balance. However, once acceleration has been stabilized, you lose that sensation of speed. You can move around, stand, or sit without any difficulty. It almost feels as if the vehicle isn't moving at all. Gravity keeps you connected to the bus, and the bus connected to the surface of the Earth, which again is spinning at a consistent speed. We will continue to not notice anything until the bus, for example, needs to suddenly stop at a bus stop or traffic light. We would then feel the deceleration based on the previously mentioned forces. The same could be said by checking back with our airplane. When we first saw the airplane that was taking off, it was accelerating at a rapid pace. The net positive force on our bodies gave us the sensation of moving forward quickly. Our otoliths were working hard, letting our bodies know that not only was it moving forward quickly, but they were also letting us know that we were climbing quickly at an increasing altitude. We will keep feeling this increase in speed and height until both become stabilized. For the remainder of the flight, we quickly lose the sense of movement, similar to the bus example. It is not until we experience external forces, such as turbulence, or we begin to reduce our altitude and speed as we prepare for landing, that we will be able to sense the change in force. So to summarize the answer to today's question, through looking at Newton's laws of motion and gravity, and looking at how we perceive these forces physically, we can say that the airplane has to push through the air. Therefore, when we jump, we simply land exactly where we began, since gravity keeps us, and everything around us, connected to the Earth's constant rotation. We hope you enjoyed finding out the answer to today's question. If there are any other questions you'd like to see answered in future videos, feel free to let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, like, subscribe, click the bell icon to get notifications for our future videos, and we'll see you in the next one.